Good morning, Cedar Park High School. It's Friday, January 18th, and it's an A-Day. I'm Ella Neal.
And I'm Evan Vines, and the Wolfcast starts now.
This year, the Austin, Texas Art Region received close to 1,700 individual submissions and 44 senior portfolios that were adjudicated by a panel of creative professionals this past Saturday, January 12th.
There were a total of 16 forms of recognition in the 2019 Scholastic Art and Writing Awards for the student submissions. A total of 4 students have won the Golden Key, the highest form of recognition in their category. Congratulations, guys. In other news, Bounty Wolves banner is up and again. It's time our cheerleaders are going to state for the championships.
The girls support us at our games, and now they're heading from the field to the finals.
Thanks, guys. You saw them on the send-off in the courtyard yesterday, and now they're on their way to hopefully another state title.
Today, the cheerleaders are on their way to the UIL championships and looking to yet again make the Timberwolves' name ring. But that title doesn't just hold itself.
So we've been practicing for about 3 months now, and we practice every day in fourth and eighth period, which is our cheer period, so for about like an hour and a half every day. So we're going into this competition as state champs from last year, so everyone kind of knows who we are, so we have a lot to live up to.
The girls take a long bus trip down to Dallas for the championships, and after a night in the hotel, are prepared to spend 12 hours on their feet. In the competition, cheerleaders from across the state come to showcase their skills and routines all day long in hopes of making the cut.
So we go against about 100 teams, and in prelims we compete each routine, so we'll compete our band dance, our fight song, and our cheer, and then from there the top 20 go to finals, and if you make top 20 you go to finals and compete to win.
This isn't solely about performance for all of the girls, especially the seniors who are hoping to reminisce in their last year as a Timberwolf.
I'm most excited to be spending time with my teammates and just being together for our last time.
Yeah, especially this being our senior year, we have to make the most of it and just make as many memories as we can.
True. Go Wolves.
With CPHS News, I'm Miranda Robertson.
Thanks, Miranda. And we wish the best of luck to our cheerleaders.
Bring home that gold.
Coming up after the break, we have your top three, your sports report, and a new episode of Dr. Love.
But first, these announcements and a quick word from our sponsor.
Texas Best Mini Donuts is a proud sponsor of CPHS News. Go check them out by CPMS and Free Wills Baptist Church off of Cypress Creek. Find them on Instagram at texas.mini.donuts.
Smoky Moe's Barbecue, the best barbecue that money can buy. Proudly supporting Cedar Park High School.
Introducing the new CPHS News app, where you can rewatch segments from the Wolfcast that you missed the day of, while you can also read top story articles from the Wolfpack and never miss the final score. Don't forget to turn on notifications to keep up to date with important alerts. Download the CPHS News app today.
Here are your top three things you need to know for today. First, new projections show that the Austin population is predicted to reach 1 million residents by 2020, joining Dallas, Houston, and San Antonio in the list of 10 U.S. cities with populations over a million. Next, the government shutdown may be affecting Super Bowl planning. Travel and security are massive parts of what it takes to run the biggest sporting event in the world, and both of these departments are seriously stunted by the shutdown. And some Super Bowl planning meetings have already been canceled. Last, 11 people were killed yesterday in a car bomb in Colombia, and at least 65 others were injured. These types of terror attacks were the norm in Colombia for a while as part of drug trafficking and leftist opposition, but it's been years since an attack of the sort. No group immediately claimed responsibility. And those are your top three things for today with CPHS News. I'm Victor Martinez. Back to you guys. Thanks, Victor. And now we have Haven Pannell and Garrett Wilson for your sports report.
Welcome to the Wolfcast Sports Report. I'm Haven Pannell.
And I'm Garrett Wilson.
Boys soccer played this past Tuesday and won against the Hutto Hippos 2-1. They will be playing tonight at 7 p.m. at home, so be sure to go
and show your support.
The girls were off this Tuesday, but they will be playing tonight against Smithson Valley at Gupton at 7, so go out and support.
Girls basketball gets yet another sweep as they wipe out Marble Falls 56-13. They will be playing tonight against the Connolly Cougars at home at 7 p.m., so be sure to come and support.
Boys basketball also played this past Tuesday and beat the Maynard Mustangs 43-37. They play tonight at Connolly, so wish them luck.
And that's all we have for you on the sports report with CPHS News. I'm Haven Pannell.
And I'm Garrett Wilson. Now check out this cheerleading hype video for our current state champion cheer team.
Your favorite boys are back with more answers and more loving for everybody.
Hello there. I'm Dr. Love.
And I'm Assistant Feelings. And the prettiest boys on the block are back with another episode of Dr. Love.
The new year brings new questions. So, Assistant Feelings, would you like to answer a question from the Fedora of Love?
Why, I sure would, Dr. Love.
And if you want to watch more, the full segment will be on our YouTube page.
Well, that's all we have for today. We hope you have a great weekend, and we will see you next week. With CPHS News, I'm Ellen Neal.
And I'm Evan Vines. Remember to make it a great day or not, the choice is yours. Have a phenomenal
day. Hey there, Haven Pannell here. If you like what you saw, make sure to hit that like button. And if you enjoy all things CPHS, hit subscribe. Have a great day or not, the choice is yours.